Hey guys, this is Anthony Morganti. I am MrPhotographer.com. In this video, I want to talk about a few different settings in Lightroom that kind of fly under the radar, but I think they're important and you should know about them. Now, before I get into that, I just got to share this with you. Those of you that watch my videos know that yesterday I did a video on the latest version of Topaz Lab Sharpen. And today I was playing around. I really like this image, but you could see that I missed focus horribly. Actually, I was shooting through plexiglass, and it really just threw off the focus. And you could see that it's kind of blurry. And I sent the image over into Topaz Lab Sharpen, and look at that. It's beautiful. So I was really impressed with that. I just wanted to show you that, but I digress. Let's talk about the settings that I'm talking about that are in Lightroom that you should know about. Now, you probably know that when you import images into Lightroom, Lightroom doesn't put you in the folder that you're importing those images into. Instead, Lightroom puts you into this previous import catalog right here. So you'll be put into this catalog. And that's okay. I mean, typically if you're importing images, you want to have them ready so you could cull them and maybe start processing them. But the problem with the previous import catalog is it doesn't allow for custom ordering, meaning I can't just go on an image here and just push it to another area, like put it over there. What will happen is I'll get this warning: the currently selected source does not support custom order, the source being previous import. And you even down here in the film strip, so if I want to grab an image and move it somewhere, it won't let me. It gets this error. So I have to be in the folder of the images. Now this setting, I'm going to tell you, it's probably not going to help you much, but if you just don't want to be in the previous import catalog when you import images, this setting will take care of that. If you go to Preferences in Lightroom, if you have a Mac, it's under the Lightroom Classic menu. If you have a PC, it's under the Edit menu. So you go to Preferences. It's in the first tab, General. Right here, select the current previous import collection during import. By default, that will be checked. If you uncheck it, unfortunately, Lightroom doesn't put you in the folder that you're importing the images into. It just keeps you right wherever you are. You may prefer that. I don't know. So I just wanted to make you aware of that. I hope someday Adobe allows you to have the option to go right into the folder where you're importing those images into, because then you'll be able to cull them like you do now. Give them star ratings, all that stuff like you do now, but you'll also be able to reorder them and put them in a custom order. So that's something I just wanted to make you aware of. I don't know how much it's going to help, but let's talk about some of these other things that are here. At the very top, show import dialog when a memory card is detected. You may not like that behavior. So if you have Lightroom open and you just put in a memory card or plug in your, let's say your camera to charge through your computer, you may not like that the import dialog pops up and kind of interrupts your workflow. And that, if that's the case, uncheck that box. Down here, treat JPEG files next to RAW files as separate folders. I believe by default that is not checked. If you shoot JPEG and RAW and that is not checked, what will happen is Lightroom will take the JPEG images and the RAW images that are on the memory card, and it will move them to the folder you're importing the images to, but it will only import into Lightroom the RAW files. The JPEGs will just be in that folder, but not in Lightroom. If you want the JPEGs and the RAW files to be in Lightroom, make sure that checkbox is checked. Replace embedded previews with standard previews during idle time. If you have a computer that Lightroom is kind of sluggish on, maybe it's crashing now and then, make sure that is not checked. Even though that is supposed to be doing it in the idle time, meaning when you're not really doing anything in Lightroom, Lightroom is just open, and what it will do, in supposed to do at least, images that just have embedded previews, it will create standard previews in the background while you're not doing anything else. Unfortunately, I've heard reports of it really making Lightroom sluggish, even when it's not supposed to be working, when you're processing an image or doing something. So make sure that's not checked if you have performance issues with Lightroom. Now, another thing I want to talk about is over here in the interface tab. Yeah, over here, these images here aren't very good. Let's go back to my monkey here, all right? Let's go back to preferences. Now over here, you could see show badges. You could see the thumbnails have badges down here in the corner. And the way it's set up with show badges, when you see them there, let's say I'm in the library module, and let's say I'm moving these around and I accidentally like click on this badge right here, it's going to bring me to the develop module. Or let's say I'm in the develop module and I accidentally click on that badge, it'll bring me back to library module. And there's other badges there that will do other things as well. And that could be annoying if you want to stay in the library module and cull your images and you're moving stuff around to get a custom order like I talked about before, and you accidentally click on a develop icon, it will bring you to the develop module. So what you can do is you go to preferences, you go to the interface, and then you ignore clicks on badges. You make sure that's clicked. And then if you accidentally click on those badges, nothing will happen. You also could just turn off the badges altogether if you prefer, and they won't be there. You could show ratings and picks, show stack counts if you use stacks. I don't use stacks, but you could do that if you want. There's other options here you should be aware of. Just go through them and make sure that Lightroom is set up the way you want it to be as far as any of these options are concerned. So these are kind of, again, minor things, but things I think you should be aware of because it may help your... Because some of these things could be aggravating if you accidentally click on a badge and you do it a lot. You know, it's aggravating. So you should know about these settings. Now I'm going to talk about something else. And this isn't in preferences. This is in catalog settings. Catalog settings, again, if you have a Mac, it's under the Lightroom Classic menu. It's under the Edit menu if you have a PC. Now in catalog settings, if we jump over to that third tab over on the far right, there's a couple things here that are kind of important. The first one is include develop settings in metadata inside of JPEGs, TIFFs, PNGs, and PSD files. If that is checked, when you edit a JPEG, TIFF, PNG, or PSD, all your edits will be written to those files. If it's not checked, your edits will stay in the Lightroom catalog. So to see your images with the edits, you'll only be able to see them in Lightroom. If you're outside of Lightroom and you go to that, say, JPEG that you think you just processed in Lightroom, it's not going to show the edits because the edits are being stored in the Lightroom catalog. But if you check this, you'll write directly to the JPEG, TIFF, PNG, and or PSD file. So then, outside of Lightroom, you open up that image, you'll see the edits. The disadvantage is whenever you write edits to an image, you run the risk of corrupting the image. Very slim, super slim. So you can see I have mine checked. So whenever I edit a JPEG, TIFF, PNG, or PSD files, I'm writing those edits right to the file. It's destructive, though. You can undo it as long as you're in Lightroom, but let's say you get rid of Lightroom and you have now this edited JPEG, TIFF, PNG, or PSD, you won't be able to undo those edits. You have to have Lightroom, the Lightroom catalog intact, where those edits were done. Then you could undo the edits. Hope that made sense. So that is important. Now, as far as raw files are concerned, by default, when you edit a raw file, Lightroom will never write to the raw file. It's non-destructive. So it's not going to write edits to the raw file. It's going to, by default, store those edits in the Lightroom catalog. If you take that raw file from outside of Lightroom and open it up in another Adobe program, like Photoshop or something, it won't see those edits because it's not necessarily communicating with the Lightroom catalog. I think more accurately, what I should say, is if you do edits on a raw file and you don't have this checkbox checked, the edits are stored in the Lightroom catalog, then if you take that raw file and send it to a colleague and you want to show them your edited file, they won't see the edits because the edits are in the Lightroom catalog. But if you automatically write changes into an XMP, the edits are written both to the Lightroom catalog and to a separate sidecar XMP file. Then you would send the raw file and the XMP file to the colleague, and they'll see the edits as long as they're using an Adobe program like Photoshop or Lightroom or something like that. So I keep mine checked. It makes you have the double amount of files. So if you have 100 raw files, when you have this checked, you're going to have 200 files. You're going to have 100 raw files and 100 XMP files. The XMP files are very small, kilobytes in size. So they really don't take up any space that's worth noting on your computer. I keep it checked. I prefer to have that checked. So that is something that you should be aware of, in my opinion. Other than that, those, you know, go through these tabs. Now on catalog settings, that really the only thing you really have to worry about is that metadata tab. And over in the preferences tab, mainly it's the general tab where you have these check marks right here. There's the interface area here too. And that's pretty much it. You have to just look around, make sure that, you know, if there's something you run into a lot, let the tooltips bother you, let's say, they keep popping up and they get in your way, they bother your concentration, turn them off. You could turn them off right there. So go through those check boxes and make sure they're set up the way you want them to be. That's it. Thank you, everyone that watches my videos. I really do appreciate it. I'll talk to you guys soon.